Hello friends, in first part of the poem, an elementary school classroom in a slum, we have seen that how is the school. Again we recap it. What is there? There is breezy wind, but the wind is not able to reach up to the faces of the students because the school is in slum area and the slum area is so dense that the breeze is not able to reach up to the students. Then we have seen that there were many students, and out of them we have seen that there is one student whose hair is not neatly done. His hair is falling on his pale face. Then there is a tall girl who is burdened by poverty, and so she has bent down. Then there is a boy who is very weak and thin, and so he is compared with the sheet of paper. Then there is a boy whose eyes are compared with the rat, means he is very much hungry. Then we have seen that there is one student who is physically disabled, and perhaps he has inherited this disability from his father. Then we are able to see one boy who is sitting on the last bench. He is not seen by the people because there is very much darkness at the last of the classroom. But he is not interested what is taught in the class, but he is interested in playing with squirrels in the tree house. Then we have seen in the second stanza that the school wall is of cream color, which is very dull and not clean, and it is covered with the images and charts which are donated by the people. There is a picture of Shakespeare, there is a picture of daybreak, and then there is a picture of sun rising and etc. But the children are not interested on this thing, and the map is different from their map because they are living in slum area and they have seen only their area, so map is not useful for them. So up to now we have seen. So now we go to the next page for our poem. So students, first line, a narrow strait sealed in with a lit sky, far, far from rivers, caps and stars of words. So what the poet says that the streets of the slum area are very narrow. As you have seen the Gully Boy, the film, in that you have seen the slum area and how were the streets that you have seen. So here also the streets are very narrow and far from rivers, means they are not able to see even the rivers, the stars, the sky and the cats. So this very narrow street, and here their future is compared to a narrow street, which means that there is no wide scope available for their future growth. These children are far away from the bright light of knowledge and education. Here, the poet wants to say this thing. Now the stanza, surely Shakespeare is wicked, the map a bad example, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal for lives that slyly turn in their cramped hole. For from fog to endless night, on their slag heap, these children were skins peeped through by bones and spectacles of steels, with mended glass like bottle bits on stones. All of their time and space are foggy slum, so blot their maps with slums as big as doom. So here students, what the poet says, surely Shakespeare is wicked. So these children are living in slum area and have faced so many hardships and therefore they feel that every other person is their enemy. So for them, Shakespeare is an evil one. Wicked means evil. So for them, Shakespeare is an evil one. The map, a bad example. Why the map is bad example? Because they don't find the map to be a good thing. Because they are living in slum area and they have not gone out of their area. So they have not seen the world. So the map is useless for them. With sheeps and sun and love tempting them to steal. Then what he says? That they desire of being loved. They also desire of being loved by other forces. But as they are not getting this, what they are doing? They are stealing them. They want to steal them. They want the love. They want to steal that love. And then for lives, they slyly turn in their cramped holes from fog to endless night. And then the poet says that they live in small homes. Okay, cramped homes. Cramped means narrow. Yani ki their houses in slum area are very small. They have started adjusting to it. Their life is going towards an endless night. See, what the way from fog to endless night. From fog to endless night means there is totally darkness. When there is fog, we are not able to see further. In the same way here, their future is not seen. It is like fog. It is like long night, totally in darkness. Their life is going towards an endless night. This means that their future is full of darkness. Right? Then what the poet says? These children were skins peeped through by bones. Yani peeped through. Peeped through means emerges. Peeped through means emerges. They are so thin that from their skin their bones are seen. The children are so thin, they are not able to get food, proper food, hygienic food, that they are so thin that from their skin we are able to see the bones from their body. And then what he says, spectacles of steel with mended glass like bottle beads on stone. And then these children are wearing glass. These children are wearing glass. And how are they? They are made of steel. They are made of steel. And they are cheap and very uncomfortable. The spectacles look like stone, which have been repaired with pieces of glass sticking out of them. Means they are wearing spectacles, but the glasses are broken. They are joined by something. Okay? And then what is there? All of their time and space are foggy slum. They are passing their time in foggy slum. Foggy slum means where they are not going to get anything. Their future is totally in darkness. So bloat their maps with slum as big as doom. So bloat their maps. Bloat here means blame. Okay? Blemish. Dark mark. So the map is for them the dark mark. Okay? And with slum as big as doom. Doom means hell. Doom here means hell. So slum area is, they are living in that area, but that area is hell for them. And how is the map? The map is the black mark for them, because they are not able to see anything out of it. Now we go to next stanza. Unless governor, inspector, visitor, this map becomes their window, these windows, that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Break, open till they break the town and show the children to green fields and make their world run as on gold sands and let their tongues run naked into the book of white and green leaves open history their whose language is the sun. So now he says that unless governor, inspector, visitor, the poet says that the government should take notice of this problem faced by these kids who are coming there to see the school. Okay, then this map becomes their window and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Catacombs means underground graves, tomb. Right? So what he says that he urges them to change the life of these kids and make the world map a reality for them. So this governor, inspector and visitors who are coming there, he requests them that they can change the life of these kids and make the world map a reality for them. Up to now, that map is a black mark to them. Okay, but these visitors or governor or inspector should make them the map a reality one. Oh break, open till they break the town and show the children to green fields. And then the poet says that he wants the governor and the public to help these kids in achieving their dreams. Okay, so they can help them to come out of the slum area and see the green fields and they can see the sun, they can see the sea and they can enjoy the life, they can see out of the world where they are living and they can run azure of gold sands. Azure means a blue sky. They should see the blue sky and they run into air. They run under this sky because they are not able to see the sky from their narrow strait. Right? And then let their tongues run naked into books and white. Books, the white and green leaves, open history. Whose language is the sun. And now the children should be allowed to read the books, the white and green leaves. White and green leaves, what the poet wants to say that? White leaf means books and green leaf means nature. The children should be allowed to read and to feel the nature, which they are not able to feel in their slum area. And history there whose language is the sun. And then there will be progress. And there will be, then they will be able to paint a bright future for themselves like the sun. Okay, students? So this is our poem. In next lecture, we will see the question answer and figures of speech. Thank you.